The top Fed tax rate on federal income, of course, 35%. President Obama says that isn't enough. The rich are not paying their fair share. So just listen to this for a second.
Fair share.
Fair shot.
Fair share.
Fair shot. Their fair share.
Fair share in taxes.
Maybe that's a little unfair. You're stringing them all together. So here is the question. What exactly is a fair share when it comes to paying federal income taxes? Let's bring in Grover Norquist from Americans for Tax Reform. He's in D.C. He is Mr. Tax. Not Mr. Tax Man. I would never say that to Grover Norquist, but he's Mr. Tax. Okay, come on. Well, it's 35% now. The president wants it to go higher. If Grover Norquist had his druthers, what would be a fair tax rate, the top tax rate on federal income?
Well, let's remember there was a bipartisan agreement that 28% was a reasonable top rate back when the Democrats voted along with Republicans for Reagan's tax reform. So we are a long way past what was considered reasonable when Reagan was president. We had both Bush 41 and then Clinton and now Obama, each one trying to push up the top marginal tax rate. Going to 25%, as Ryan and Romney have talked about, only gets us back to Reagan levels, and I think that's too high, but that's not a bad place to start.
You know, I said on this program that I would be prepared to pay that because there's a moral thing here. Is it moral for a government to take a third of your income or half your income? And I say, no, it's not. But I said I would draw the line at one third. If you could get me to one third as the top tax rate, 33% as the top tax rate, I would be satisfied with that. But that's not good enough for you. You want to go way down to a quarter or less. Now, again, given your
You would be peasant during the Middle Ages because it was about 25% there. So you're willing to pay more than the serfs had to pay during the Middle Ages.
Was it 25%?
25%
really?
For serfs, yeah.
Where would you put it? Would you go to 20%? Would you go to 15? Where'd you go?
Well, I think you start by going to 25 and moving there. And then I think we need to take it down. There's several benchmarks you look at. The American people believe no one, 75% of Americans argue no one should pay more than 25% of their income in all taxes. That includes state and local taxes as well. So the American sense of fairness has most Americans arguing for something significantly less than 25%.
Well, Grover, what about consumption taxes? Because that hits everybody, regardless of your income, at the same rate. Are you in favor of that kind of flat tax on consumption?
Well, we can take the income tax and make it a consumption tax by expanding IRAs and 401ks. So you don't need a new tax to eliminate the double and triple and quadruple taxation we have on savings and investment in America. But let's keep an eye on where Obama and the Democrats want to go. All this talk about taxing the rich is nonsense. The Buffett tax raises $47 billion over 10 years at a time when Obama's planning on spending, getting $11 trillion in new debt, okay? So he's going to fund one half of 1% of his new debt by taxing rich people. The rest is coming out of everybody in America. How? A value-added tax or an energy tax? An energy tax, a carbon tax, is a value-added tax on training wheels. It will immediately go to an across-the-board tax on consumption of that. And when we have a VAT, we are irrevocably on the path to Europe.
You know, you say the last. You're burying the lead. You got to put it right up front, Grover. You know, you know these things. You got to do it right. But Grover Norquist, it is always a pleasure. Thanks for joining us, sir. Frightening stuff.
Thank you.
But it's good to hear it. Thank you.